Well, well, as the year is coming to an end, some people are preparing for, you know, surprises for their loved ones. But it has come to our notice that someone has received his own bag of surprise. You know, it's not even MTN season of surprise, but somebody has gotten, you know, surprise. So, a Nigerian lady has come out with claims that singer Flavor, you know, Flavor Navania, well, him, that he's the father of her three-year-old daughter. Pause. And you understand? Digest it. Somebody said that Flavor is the, you know, the father of her child. Well, this woman, who her name is Juliet Oluchi Ehiemere, claims that she met Flavor in 2015 and took in for him. She says that all she wants is for the singer to take care of the child. Now, Juliet, in a post she made on an Instagram page which she opened two days ago, she said that she is ready to face the consequences if a DNA test proves otherwise. She said, and I quote, "My name is Juliet Oluchi Ehiemere from Abia State. I'm 33 years old. And this post will make you do either of two things: judge me and call me names, or support me in getting justice for my daughter. I sincerely hope you do the latter. The picture you see is a picture of my 3 years and 4 months old daughter, Stephanie Chidinma Chinedu Okoli, whom I bore for Chinedu Okoli, popularly known as Flavor." This is about to be a long read. Now, she said that she met Flavor sometime in 2015 and took it for him. And ever since, she has made attempts to contact him, but he has since then ignored her. She said she's not another gold digger. That's what she said. And all she wants is for Flavor to take care of his daughter. She said she's reported the matter to the Office of the Public Defender in Lagos State. And she is challenging Flavor to come out for a DNA test. Wow. Anyways, she said that if the DNA test shows that Flavor, that he's not the father, that she's ready to pay for the penalties. For her to say all of this, I feel like she really knows what she's saying, and I feel like Flavor should actually pay attention to what she's saying now. You know, she said, according to her, she said that the pain, she could have ignored it, but the pain and suffering which she and her daughter is too much for them to bear, and she is done keeping silent. She said her daughter and her cannot keep suffering the way she is. And she also asked other people to repost the story till Flavor sees this. I hope Flavor sees this and goes to no check on where the ceiling is leaking in this house. You understand what I'm saying? She said she's not even afraid to show herself. So, what do you think about this, first of all? I personally think, as I said before, I feel like she knows what she's saying. And for her to involve the, you know, the state authorities, it means that she knows what she's saying. And I feel like Flavor should actually go and, you know, check. But some people have come out on social media. Y'all play a lot. Some people have come out on social media to say, but she's not a beauty queen. How did she get pregnant for Flavor? Yes, stop. Thing is, okay, it's a trend. True, it's a trend that all Flavor's baby mamas are beauty queens. Yeah, but most beautiful girl in Nigeria for different years. Or they have been contestants. And now this lady, who nobody really knows about, she said she met him. She met him in 2015. So we don't really know about it until the DNA test, you know, is carried out. Then we can finally confirm that this Flavor have another child to have his son name. Because as it is now, the lady has already given him the son name. But a lot of you sisters that are scheming something, maybe because you have seen that, this one named her daughter this, you want to go and try it. Hope you have DNA test to prove it. Because this one is shouting that she wants DNA test. Maybe because, you have seen that you have cash belay somehow for somebody, the person don't want it. You now say, Davido Adeleke, let's just put that son name attached to it. If you don't have DNA test, what's going to happen? You see that thing that happened to those two girls? Well, nothing really happened to them. They arrested them, they released them, and they flexed them. But you don't know how your own is going to be, but don't try. I feel like you shouldn't even try to defame somebody's name when you know you don't have evidence.